Langston Hughes, The Negro Speaks of Rivers, dedicated to the heroes of the Civil Rights Movement. It was my dedication. I've known rivers. I've known rivers ancient as the world, and older than the flow of human blood and human veins. My soul has grown deep like the rivers. I bathed in Euphrates when dawns were young. I built my hut near the Congo, and it lulled me to sleep. I looked upon the Nile and raised the pyramids above it. I've heard the singing of the Mississippi. When Abe Lincoln went down to New Orleans, and I've seen its muddy bosom turn all golden in the sunset. I've known rivers, ancient, dusty rivers. My soul has grown deep like the rivers. Langston Hughes. Some of these images that I have produced are, you know, each one has a story, of course, just remembering where and how I came to these images. This woman is a woman that lives in South Carolina. The image here, these are her hands, by the way. And this has happened. It was an old pot in the yard, and it was an old rusty pot in her backyard. And I saw her hands, and her hands have always fascinated me. And so seeing her hands and seeing this rusty pot, I said, whoa, veins that run through the blood, as the line goes, older than the flow of human blood and human veins. My God, to see her, the blood, you can actually almost feel the blood running through her veins. Her hands had stories. You could just tell, countless stories just by looking at her hands. And so to see this pot that had also that character, that age, and that weathering, what the combination. So I said, well, I got to do that. And she said, can you hold this pot for me? And she said, and I, to turn it this way and turn it that way. And so taking several shots of that. This is my nephew here, and an old guy that I was out on the street working on a building. And the guy that was supposed to be the grandfather in this situation didn't show up. And so I'm sitting here with my nephew, it's great light, getting ready to lose the light. And I'm like, whoa, I need to find an old guy. So I run around the neighborhood like, an old guy, And I run over to him, he's got a hammer and whatever in his hand. He's like trying to knock down this, this window out of this building. Excuse me, I got a, kind of a proposition for you. You want to make a couple dollars? Huh? I said, oh yeah, I'm doing this photo shoot and I need you to play a granddad. Granddad? Well, yeah, my nephew here, I need you to be his granddad, and you need a fish on this pond across the street over here. Okay. And I convinced him, and he came over, sat down. He was great. And he sat there, and he played granddad. And he actually, he didn't want to leave because he was having so much fun.